स्क्रीन इज विजिबल। Okay, so till now we discuss about detail estimator. Now let's see methods of detail estimate. The dimensions, length, breadth and height or depth are to be taken out from the working drawings. So you have to, from drawings, you have to take the length, breadth and height or depth. Junction of walls, corners and the meeting points of the walls require special attainments. Why? Because in junction, suppose let me draw with my note is okay. Okay, so this is the junction. This is a, suppose this is a room, you need to do estimate at this junction. Suppose you will be given this length, right? Or you will have this breadth. So suppose you are estimating this wall, you are considering the whole outer to outer length, right? Again, for this breadth, you again taking this outer. So this will, there will be an overlap of the quantity. So you have to take care of this at junctions and corners. So basically, detail estimates, in your practical class, you must have got this individual long wall or short wall method. Here they have written separate or individual wall method, or you can say long wall and short wall method and center line method, right? In separate or individual wall methods, also called as long wall and short wall, the walls running in one direction are termed as long walls and the walls running in the transverse direction as short walls, without keeping in mind which wall is lesser in length. Length of long walls are measured for, so basically I don't need to discuss this because this has been this already been discussed by another, by Gayatri ma'am and Anandita ma'am, right? So you go through these methods. So see, that was I was talking about. Suppose for estimating this wall, you have taken outer to outer. Okay, let me note. Suppose in estimating this wall, you have taken the length outer to outer. Okay, now when you estimate this wall, don't take this much length, because this length is already covered in this part. So you have to take this much breadth only, because this part is considered in this length. Okay. So I will not discuss this center line method and long wall short wall method, because these methods have been discussed by your ma'am. So description and units of measurements for common items. So if you remember, one sheet was distributed among all of you, that there it was mentioned that earthwork will be considered as this unit. This painting is considered as meter cube, like all the specification means units of measurement, not specification, units of measurement was given. So let's recall that the item is described in detail, but the price of the this item is usually included as lump sum. So for site clearance works, so before constructing a site, you have to clear the site or not? Suppose if you are constructing a road, you have to take out all the vegetation there, right? You have to, if there are some plants, some if it is forest, you have to clear those forests. You have to make a path to make construct a road, and to make a building, you have to clear all the garbages. All you have to make site clear, then only you'll start work. So for site clearance, usually we used to take a lump sum amount. The cost of this item is provided in estimate by judgment according to the description of the item and is indicated as lump sum. So for site clearance work, we used to take lump sum value. Excavation for foundation trenches. So for excavation part, what you need length, breadth and you need length, breadth and depth. Earthwork in excavation for foundation trenches is calculated by taking the dimension of yes Suraj, your voice is cracking, so better you type in the chat box. So for excavation we generally take meter cube, or you can take cubic feet, cubic yard or cubic meter according to the prevailing practice. So basically we used to take cubic meter. Okay, the payment for this item is generally done as rupees per 100 cubic feet, or you can say per 100 meter cube. So for 100 meter cube a rate will be described. So suppose 1000, so multiply those 1000 with the 100 rate. Filling in trenches after the construction of foundation masonry is ordinarily neglected. If the trench filling is also taken in account, it may be calculated by deducing the volume of masonry in trenches from that of the volume of excavation. So after excavation, you might need some filling. So how can you find out the filling quantity? How much is the volume we have excavated minus volume of masonry? From the volume of excavation, suppose you have digged out 5 square meter and the masonry work was 5, you have excavated 5 meter cube and excavation part was 3 meter cube. How much is the left? 2 meter cube. So that will be your filling part. Now foundation in PC, the type of concrete must be clearly mentioned. The mix proportion and the type of cement, sand and coarse aggregate must be specified. So in foundation we do a PCC, or you can say brick soling or stone soling. Okay, this item is measured in cubic feet, or you can say a meter cube. So like this, every item is discussed here. And in units of measurements also, brickwork, plastering, painting, every work rate has been described. Now brickwork is superstructure. There are some important consideration you have to take. Measurements of wall shall be taken in the same order, in the same and in the same manner as for brickwork and foundation. So basically brickwork and foundation, you can take bricks are laid in 1:4 or 1:6. So the same way brickwork will be considered in superstructure as in foundation. All openings such as doors, windows, veranda openings, etc. shall be neglected. Yes. See, when you construct a, in the last class only, I was present in your class. I asked you to do the estimation of your class. So many of you considered the whole wall, but there were some cutouts where windows were attached. So when you considered the brickwork in a wall, you have to neglect the window parts, ventilation parts and door parts. Okay. Don't take the whole length and breadth and height. You have to minus the length, breadth, height of the windows, doors and lintels. These are the important consideration. Number three is the quality of bricks and mortar ratio have to be specified. You have to specify what there are different types of bricks. So what bricks are you using and what is the mortar ratio? Mortar, we have discussed in construction engineering materials, right? Mortar is nothing but cement, sand and water, right? Masonry for arches shall be spayed separately at a different rate. So see, when you in some houses, there will be some arc shape involved in entrance or in some, there will may be some special cutouts. So for that, you have to pay labors or masoner extra money. Okay, for that charges will be different for those special cutouts and arches. The height of superstructure is very important. Generally, the quantities are worked out for each story separately, and rates would be different for different stories because of additional labor work, scaffolding, and shuttering. So when you go higher, rates can be different by each floor. Suppose you are constructing for G plus 5 building. So for G plus 5 building, for fifth floor rate may be different, for fourth floor may be different. The rate will depend upon the local contractor or at which rate you can fix if it is private work. The item is worked out in CFT and the standard unit of payment is okay. Basically, we generally take cubic meter in India, okay, and the rate is per cubic meter. For DPC, these are the conditions given. So go through, I'll share this PPT. Each and go through every detail, every unit, which actually these are mentioned in units of measurements only. The sheet ma'am provided you all the units is measured. So based on those units, payments were made. So you go through all these slides. You don't understand, we'll discuss in the next class. Okay. So now let's move to some common relation used in building estimate. There are some relations. Mortars. Okay. So basically, thumb rules are given. I'll give you in this. These units are used in forens. Okay. I'll give you a thumb rule. Thumb rule means basically the general from the experience from the work these if you you have to use that much amount only. Okay, so I'll share that also, but you go through this slides also. I'll share one more slide of thumb rules. Okay, that for this much amount of work, suppose for 100 meter cube of concrete you will require this much amount of cement, this much amount of aggregate, and this much amount of water. So that is a thumb rule. Basically, these are thumb rules given. I want to go to the numerical. Okay, yeah, estimation of a simple building. So let's start as quick. We don't have a problem in our this class. Okay, in subject this problem discussion is not mentioned, but I want to discuss a numerical so that it may be the theory I have taught you gets easy for you to understand. So this is a plan given to you, and also as practicals classes were already done, so you are more familiar with this, I guess. So it is a plan given. Two rooms are given. One room is 10 feet, 10 by 12. Another room is 12 by 12, and veranda is your 9 by 9, I guess. Yes. Window sizes are given. Door sizes are given. So these are the windows. Let me note. So these are the windows. 4 by 4 windows, these are the door 4 by 7, and the thickness is given. All the measurements are given. This is one thing, this is written as S. I can, this is also a, okay, let's start the numerator. So from this plan, these will be the columns. One, two, you have to first place the columns also. The columns will be at this place, and this place. So when there is a column, there will be a foundation also, right? Here it will be a column. Here it will be a column. Again, column. Here it will be a column. So you see, they have mentioned, they have shown the column with square and these two diagonal lines. So you will have three columns in a row. Okay, So these are the column placings. So the if there is a column, so that will it represents foundation below the ground, right? So let's see. This is the foundation given. Two types of foundation is given. Maybe could you change the color of the point? Okay. I'm not able to change the cursor color. Let me try. No option for this. I can annote only it different colors. Okay. Okay, you want me to annote in the other earlier? Okay, let me try. These are your column positions. When you see a lot of diagram, you do a lot of estimate, you will be able to do estimate in your mind itself. You can, that is the thumb rule. That this much amount, this building will cost us this much. So it's actually, this subject needs a lot of practical knowledge. Practical, not knowledge, practical practice. This practice. You just simply take out a plan and start doing estimate. You will be a hero one day. Okay, so these were the position of columns. Okay, so two types of foundation were given. Maybe this these columns may be of large size, and this column has large foundation, or the size of the column is more, and the inner columns may be small. So basically, this is the DPC. These are the various filling layers. These are the step footings. So these are the PCC. Then these are the step concrete, and this is the column raised. Okay. Now to start with the estimation of this. Specification is given for the plan. Clear height of rooms is 12. Clear height of veranda is 10. That is the floor height actually. Plinth level is 1:6. 1 foot 6 inch. Thickness of roof slab is given 4 inch. 3 inch depth. So these are the basically specifications given. Now they have take out the center to center length first. 10, 12. Okay, let's 10, 12, 4.5, 4.5, 4.5. So if you see the figure, okay, it will be difficult to go back. So center to center till length, which length they have taken? Tell me. They have taken. Okay, let's do one thing. You go through this PPT, you go through this slides. Then only we'll discuss again once again, okay? Then that will be more easy. Bill of Kasui. After taking out the all the quantities, they have done the bill of quantities. For earthwork, so this is the way we used to write. Earthwork, excavation in foundation trenches. L1, S1, S2, S3. So L1 is one kind of length. Which, so L1 has, suppose L1 is 9 foot. And you have three, they have in the diagram 3 L1. That means three lengths are in 9 foot. Sorry, three lengths are 25 foot, 7.5. Two lengths are 10 foot 3 inch, one is 10 foot 3 inch, and two are 5 foot 6 inch. These are the lengths, these are the breadths, and these are the depths. Now if quantity you can find, length into breadth into height. In remarks, they have represented the how they have got the length. Okay. Breadth and depth are simply same. The main thing, the main confusion part is to find out the length sometimes. So after they got the quantity, length, breadth into height, quantity, you can find out the total quantity by multiplying the number 3. Okay, your quantity is your length, breadth and height. You got the quantity. Now the total quantity will be this quantity multiplied by this 3. You will get the total quantity. So this is okay. So this much is the total quantity for earthwork for excavation in foundation trenches. So 1024.52 CFT is the total quantity for earthwork in excavation. इन द सेम वे विल डू फिर नंबर टू इज फिलिंग आफ्टर एक्सकावेशन वी हैड कंस्ट्रक्टेड सो देयर अर्थवर्क इन फिलिंग्स अंडर फ्लोर्स विल बी फॉर रूम नंबर वन देयर विल बी वन फिलिंग फॉर रूम नंबर टू फॉर रूम फॉर वरंडा दे हैव कैरीड आउट द समेशन ऑफ लेंथ एंड डेप्थ नाउ दिस इज द क्वांटिटी नाउ पीसीसी वर्क अगेन सो दिस इज द वे to find to do the estimation of to take out the quantities basically we are taking out the quantities okay so this is the way to taking out the all the quantities okay so for, we start with the foundation then filling then DPC brickwork Now, for brickwork, they have deduced deduction. What is the deduction? They have deduct the door sizes, window size, ventilator, shelves. Okay, S1 was in the figure. The S is represented as shelves. Then RCC lintel over doors. So they have all deducted all. Okay, so all the deduction was 116.18 CFT. But they have deducted one. So in this way there will be an this way we used to do the estimation we first this is the way to find out all the taking out all the quantities now after taking out all the quantities we used to placed in price bill let me show you now this is the abstract of quantity so earlier was total detail taking out now we'll just sum up the quantities So excavation in medium soil total we got 1025.52. PCC was total this much. They have added some extra also. So that you have found out for one floor, right? For second floor there may be some extra. There won't be an excavation, but then the repeated if the same pattern the building has been constructed same rooms or floors veranda is given in the same position so it will be repeated to till the upper floors okay in this way let me show you they have abstracted all the quantities in one place now they will in price bill they will just multiply so this is the summary of all the work cement 220.6 CFT or 177 bags sand is this much coarse aggregate so this is the abstract of all the materials okay price bill is not mentioned here so please go through this PPT you will understand more I'll try to give you a video as I last discussed I'll try to give you a video better video so that you can understand an estimation of simple G+1 building sorry G+2 building so that it can be easy for your 7th and 8th semester project work okay then that's all for today you can write your roll numbers in the chat box Don't leave the class as I'm taking a screenshot of the participant list, okay? Okay, those who wrote their roll number, they can leave the classroom.